Google just dropped a new coding CLI called Gemini CLI. It's almost similar to Claude Code CLI. This CLI is open source and free to use up to a certain limit. You can check the blog here. It has free limit uses for 60 model requests per minute, 1000 model requests per day, and it is open source. Yes, so the daily quota gets resets every day. It's not like Copilot, which gets monthly free quota. And you can use Gemini 2.5 Pro model with this CLI too. So let's see how to get installed this on your system. So this is a Gemini CLI repo. And if we go down in the readme, you can see there is a pre-request for node version. So to node version, you have to go to the node site and install the respective node executable for your system. My is Windows, so I'm using Windows installer. So after you install the node version, make sure you restart your terminal and type this command, node v. If this shows you number, that means your node was successfully installed. Now our next step is to install the Gemini CLI. We're going to copy this code and paste in terminal and click enter. So our tool is installed successfully. To start a Gemini CLI, we are going to type Gemini in the terminal and press enter. This will open a certain kind of window. You can see that. So it says tip for getting started, ask questions, edit files, create a Gemini MD files and help. So first is asking for theme selections. So you can choose your respective themes. As you can see on the right side, it says Gemini 2.5 Pro. That means this CLI is using Gemini 2.4 for the context. Now the second step is to log in with Google. Select the authentication method. Now the second step is select the authentication method. So the first option is login with Google. Second is Gemini API key and Vertex AI. So for the easy usage, I'm going to log in with Google. Select login with Google and press enter. Okay, so I provided authentication for the Google. You can also use Gemini API key from Google AI Studio and put the API key here. That will also work. So this UI has given some instructions and an input field where we are going to type a message. Suppose I type hi. Okay, that means our Gemini CLI is working. Now I'm going to create a project with this CLI and let's see, will it able to create and modify the project's files? So we're going to right click, click on terminal, type Gemini, and now we are going to write, create a Chrome extension with React.js and JS project. This extension should be able to read a blog and summarize to create a LinkedIn post. Let's see how it does. Click enter. So it's asking permission to allow execution. Allow always. Okay, we can see a project is being created right now. We're going to open this project in VS Code. You can see on the right side, Gemini 2.5 Pro, it says 99% context left. That is for the today's quota. Okay, so node modules has been installed. Let's read for the HTML and JavaScript files. Okay, source file and public file has been created. Okay, so it says all npm packages are installed, npm start to start the server, everything, LinkedIn post generator. I have created a React project. Now I will create a manifest file in the public directory. Obviously for Chrome extension, you need a separate manifest file. This file will definitely define the extension's name, version, permission, script, sure. Allow always. Okay, so you see, here is the manifest file for the Chrome extensions, and it given every path for default pop-up index HTML for background service and for the content script. These are the necessary file for a Chrome extension. I have created a background script. Let's see, okay, it has created these files. After the manifest, it says I have created a manifest JSON file. Now we'll create a content script. In the public directory, this script will extract the blog post content from the active tab. Sure. I have created a content script. It is complete. Now background JS in the public directory to handle the communications. That's it. And it created every file. Do you want to try run build? Yes, always. You can choose allow once, but I'm choosing always. Okay, the build failed because Chrome object is not defined in the React environment. It will handle a placeholder for the Chrome object app.js. Okay, so the Chrome object is not defined. For that, you need to install a package regarding Chrome, probably. So it says, I have added a placeholder for Chrome object. Now I will try to rebuild the project. Okay, so it saw the error and retrying to fix it and rebuilding it again. Let's see. Okay, I think now it's completed and it's ready. You can add a post name. Let's see. Let's go to the build folder. So build folder is our final extensions. We have manifest file. That is the main file to be used. Now let's go to the Chrome extensions and click on manage extensions. Enable the developer mode and pick load and patch options. Now what we are going to do is Android Studio Gemini post and build folder and click select. Well, it get loaded. That means the extension was properly created and built with no error. Now it will work or not, that's a different case, but at least Chrome extension is successfully created. Now let's go to any blog. Suppose this is my own blog, Gemini CLI, and click on extension and click LinkedIn post generator. Okay, so it's a UI issue. Let's go to the terminal. It says fix pop-up view set width as 300 pixels and height 400 pixels. So after making changes, we need to rebuild the project and reload in our extension. So it's redefining the CSS files and everything. Okay, it's added the height extensions. Okay, it's building. Okay, it's ready to use. So let's go to the extension and click reload. Reloaded successfully, and now let's see. Okay, it performed very well. Now click on summarize blog post. Nothing happened. Why did nothing happen? Because let's go to the inspect element, click console. Okay, so summarize blog post is doing nothing. Again, we are going to do terminal and type the summarize button is doing nothing. It should read blog and summarize to a LinkedIn post. Okay, it restructured the logic. Rebuilding the logic. Shift tab to toggle. Okay. Okay, so it's done. We're going to reload it. Refresh and open the extensions. Okay, it's working. So it took me hardly like 10 minutes to generate this comment section that will generate a LinkedIn post from a blog. So if we scroll down, it says free open source Gemini tool CLI and every other things. There are some other scrapping things. We can filter this out for developers command line. So we can filter it out, make it more work, but everything as a POC, it's working. And our Gemini CLI is 100% approved. So I've not started with the CLI tool. You can start with Gemini CLI and start vibe coding with it. And the quota is almost very good enough for a single developer. 60 more requests per minute, that is more than enough that we can use. So this Gemini CLI also contains some powerful tools, like it can use Google search to perform its actions. It can extend Gemini CLI abilities by using MCP and more to come. So let me know how you like this video. Like and subscribe this channel to get more videos on AI and Flutter.